Hey guys, this is Ron here, RA Quarter Horses 1. I wanted to take this opportunity while I'm just riding and enjoying the day to talk to y'all a little bit about prepping. As y'all, a lot of y'all know, I try to, well, call myself a prepper, I guess. I have a garden, I pressure tan, we raise hogs, we raise chickens, we kill them, put them in the freezer, can them, which whatever. Also, we deer hunt, try to put a couple of deer in the freezer each year if we can. And it really helps out on the food bill. Now, I have went and bought some of those lids, gamma lids, for 5-gallon buckets. Now, I don't have a bunch of food stored up in 5-gallon buckets, all dried food, but here's what I do. I got 5-gallon bucket full of sugar that I use out of every day. I just unscrew the lid. I keep a measuring cup in there so I can just scoop out a cup of sugar if I need it. And I do the same thing with flour. Now I've got some more lids and I plan on doing the same thing with cornmeal. And later maybe even some, you know, dried beans. My food don't sit there on the shelf and you not use it. And you know, the day could come that something extremely bad happens and we never have sugar again. You know, we're flour. But the way I see it, most events are small. Usually, they pass in a week or two. And 5 gallons of sugar, 5 gallons of flour, that lasts me quite some time. Actually, a lot of times at our home, with all the kids we got, and drink all the tea we drink, and Kool-Aid, that 5-gallon bucket of sugar still lasts us about 3 months. So, it's always on hand. I see it start getting low. I go buy another big bag of sugar at Walmart. A big bag of sugar is only about $14. I think it's 10. No, maybe it's 20 pounds. It's a pretty good size bag. And Save-A-Lot has flour in those big sacks too. But that's how I prep. And I kind of like to think my horses, buggy and all that's prepping too. Because come down to it, if I didn't have gas, there was no gas. We could still have transportation. Hey, I remember, guys, when the tornadoes hit close to the house a couple of years ago, knocked the electricity out. We didn't have gas for over a week. There was one gas station that somehow wired up a generator to one of their gas pumps, and there was people lined up for almost a mile wanting to get gas. Now, I always keep my vehicles full if I can help it. And I did that. I had gas then, and I always put gas back in my generators. I didn't have to stand in line and wait on gas like all those other people did. I spent my time enjoying life instead of sitting in the line being frustrated. So those little things can help a whole lot, guys. Y'all just keep that in mind. Also, you know, I don't do shout-outs very often, but I want to do a shout-out to Misty Shooter 223. I think now she's got a Modern Homesteader channel, or she's on there with a bunch of others. Y'all go check her out. Her and her family, they live up in Tennessee with the Mennonites in the Mennonite area, and they live that same type of lifestyle. And they really have the prepping going on, the prepping and the homesteading. And she can teach you a whole lot. She's got a great family, a great husband, they homeschool. I believe if something was to happen today, her kids could make it without them, even if they had to. So y'all go check out Misty Shooter 223. She's on YouTube as well as Facebook. And like I said, they've got this new thing, Modern Homesteaders. Check them out as well. Tell them I sent you. Remember guys, tough times don't last, tough people do.